to give her what I wasn't giving her. But the tone of the response told me she was
in a quarter mile, keep right to stay on I-10 West.
Of our marriage because I was unable to fill my role as a husband due to legitimate injury and kept the affair going for, at that point, nearly an entire year. But the idea of her losing me to
keep right to stay on I-10 West.
Waiver? What an effing weakling. Now, during all of this, I was also exacting the second part of my plan.
Continue on I-10 West for 3 miles.
In order financially, in September, I had met with a family attorney to get the ball rolling on divorce papers with the mountain of evidence I'd piled up to that point. New York is an at-fault state as far as divorce, and the overwhelming amount of proof I'd gathered displaying Sue's infidelity pretty much solidified I could nail her to the effing wall in a divorce case. My lawyer instructed me to get all of my financials in order in preparation for whatever division of assets might come as a result. I went one better than that, secretly pulling all of my money out of our joint account and putting it in my personal account. I also started shopping around for an apartment as part of phase two. We're now in November, and I've not changed my behavior. In fact, I've ramped it up. This is where my friend Nina comes into play. For context, Nina and Sue have never been what you call close. I met Nina freshman year of high school, 2 years before I met Sue. Even way back then, Sue has seen Nina as a threat, as she's my closest female friend. There's always been an implied I don't trust her from Sue regarding Nina. She's never
addressed. In 2 miles, take exit 357 for Florida 103 Lane Avenue.
Firstly, Nina's never been a big fan of Sue. Early in me and Sue's relationship, Nina called to attention to me how Sue was pretty much imposing herself into our little square of friends, whereas I didn't do the same with Sue's set of friends. That irked Nina because she knew why Sue was doing it, her. Among Sue's circle, even now, there are no male friends, aside from POS, whereas Nina is the only girl in my square. Nina had been stuck overseas due to the virus and finally returned to New York City on November 3rd. Oz, Joey, and I decided we were going to celebrate her return with a night at Joey's house for dinner and drinks. There was only 5 of us, Oz, Joey, Joey's wife, who is also Nina's sister, Nina, and myself. Sticking to CDC guidelines, we take the Rona very seriously. Nina, being the evil mastermind she is, comes up with an evil idea to trigger Sue. She suggested we take some photos in the same vein of the photos I discovered of Sue and POS months prior and post them to my Facebook. And that's just what we did. It wasn't until the 5th that Sue got wind of it, as I'm guessing a few friends noticed my updates and saw how uncomfortably close I was with Nina. This really effed her mind up, because she still believed I was cheating, and I can almost guarantee she wanted to accuse Nina. But she knew that Nina had been stuck in Europe for the majority of the year. Still didn't stop her from attempting.
In half a mile, take exit 357 for Florida 103 Lane Avenue.
I saw this as a golden opportunity to deliver the lead jab for my knockout blow. I say, so what about the pics with you and POS from last year? He was pretty handsy in them, but did you see me get bent out?
Take exit 357, then keep left at the fork.
It was the first time I even mentioned the dude's name throughout all of this. The hamster wheel in her head started reeling in real time as she tried to explain.
Keep left at the fork.
To that point, she hadn't even known I saw them. That's how little I use Facebook. When I actually do post something, it's like an event to people, which is why the pics with Nina specifically got so much traction among our circles. And explain away she did, he's that way with everyone, he's just a really friendly guy. I can see how it looks, but there's nothing there. I'm sorry if those pics hurt you, I'll delete them. No, the pics aren't what hurt me. The year you've been effing the dude whilst lying to me that you're working extra hours and hanging with friends is what hurt me. But vengeance, as Lieutenant Commander Worf from Star Trek The Next Generation so famously said, is a dish best served cold. From that night, Sue was being extra specially clingy and attentive to me, like annoyingly so. She's trying to initiate affection and intimacy with me, and I'd stonewall her at every chance. All the while, I'm still archiving.